This session I am going to discuss about no load current calculation for single phase core type transformer. First, you people will be wondering, what is the term no load current? Current means if you load, then only current will flow, right? What is the meaning of no load current? In transformer, we got two winding. One is primary winding, which is connected with the supply. Secondary winding, which is connected with the load. So whenever you connect the primary winding with the supply, okay, it will produce the flux on the core. That flux will interact with the secondary winding and EMF will get induced on the secondary winding. Now if you connect load, then the secondary current will flow. If you are not connecting load, then the I2 value, the secondary current value, will become zero. But primary will be drawing the current, because it need to set up the flux lines. For that, it will draw the current. That current is called no load current. So that no load current, this no load current consists of two part. One is magnetizing current component, another one is loss component, IL value. So by adding these two, IM and IL, we can get the I0 value, that is no load current value. Here IM is called magnetizing current and IL is loss component current. Therefore, to calculate no load current, we need to calculate magnetizing current and loss component current. How to calculate magnetizing current? To calculate the magnetizing current, we need to calculate the MMF required for the full transformer. MMF required for the transformer. If you know the MMF required for the transformer, then we can calculate the IM value. Similarly, to calculate the IL value, we need to calculate the core loss or iron loss, the full iron loss. If we know, then we can calculate the IL value. Okay, so first we need to calculate IM, then we need to calculate IL. If we add both, then we will be getting the I0 value. For that, first we need to understand the dimensions. So this section is called core, and these sections are called yoke. So LC is length of core, LY is length of yoke. And this section, this part is called window for the given transformer. So this dimension is WW, width of window. And this is height of window. HW is height of window. Now, MMFC. What is the MMFC? This is the MMF required for the core. MMF required for the core is denoted as MMFC. MMFY. That is MMF required for the yoke. Okay, then ATC. ATC is nothing but core MMF, core ampere turns per meter. So for 1 meter, how much ampere turns? That is ATC. Similarly, ATY is the yoke ampere turns per meter. So to calculate a MMF, what to do? We have to multiply by the total length. We will get MMFC. To get MMFY, ATY into total length of yoke, we will get a MMFY. Okay, right. Then ATO, what is the ATO? ATO is nothing but a total magnetizing MMF. So to calculate total magnetizing MMF, we need to add the ATC, ATY, and total MMF we need to calculate. So that is ATO, total magnetizing MMF. PP, number of primary turns. Since no load current will flow only on the primary winding, we should use the TP, number of primary turns. So the no load current will not flow on the secondary winding. It will flow only on the primary winding. So we are considering the TP value, number of primary turns. Now, we need to calculate the total length of core. What is the total length of core? Here we got the two cores, LC, LC, for a single phase core type transformer. So the total length of core becomes 2LC. Then total length of yoke. Similarly, we got a top LY and the bottom LY. So the total length of yoke will be 2LY. Now we need to calculate MMF required for the core, that is MMFC. MMF required for the core is nothing but a MMF per meter for the core, ATC, into total length of core, 2LC. So ATC into 2LC, we will get a 2ATCLC. This is for MMF required for the core. Similarly, MMF required for the yoke. How to calculate MMF required for the yoke? MMF per meter required for the yoke, that is ATY, into total length of yoke. Total length of yoke is 2ly. So if you multiply both, we will get a 2a ty ly. So that is MMF required for the yoke. This is MMF required for the core. This is MMF required for the yoke. Now we need to calculate total MMF. So the total magnetizing MMF. Total magnetizing MMF is nothing but a MMF required for the core, MMF required for the yoke, and MMF required for the joints. See, this is here. This is core part. This is yoke part. And if you are using 2L core and this, that opposite part become joints. You will get a 2 joints if you are using L core. If you are using I core, then you will get a 4 joints. So the MMF required for the joints also we need to include. So the total MMF is nothing but a MMF required for the core, MMF required for the yoke, and a MMF required for the joints. If you add all, then we will get a total magnetizing MMF. So total magnetizing MMF is MMF required for the core, MMF required for the yoke, MMF required for the joints. So MMF required for the core we calculated, that is 2A TCLC. This is MMF required for the core. This is MMF required for the yoke. So MMF required for the core 2A TCLC, MMF required for the yoke 2A TYLY, and MMF required for the joints. If you add all together, we will get a MTO. Total magnetizing MMF for the core type transformer. So from here we can calculate the maximum value of magnetizing current. Maximum value of magnetizing current is nothing but ATO divided by TP, because we, this is AT, ampere turns, we want ampere, so we have to divide by the turn. ATO divided by TP, since the current will flow, no load current will flow only on the primary winding, we have to divide by the TP value. So Imax, the maximum value of no load current is maximum value of magnetizing current. Maximum value of magnetizing current is nothing but ATO divided by TP, which will give the maximum value of magnetizing current. But normally we will never use the maximum value or the peak value. We will use RMS value. In electrical engineering, wherever we use current, the current value should be noted, denoted by the RMS value. So from maximum value, how to get the RMS value? We have to divide by root 2. So if we assume the sinusoidal waveform, then we have to divide by root 2. The maximum value we have to divide by root 2. So ATO divided by root 2 TP will give the RMS value of magnetizing current. If you are not sure about the waveform, if it is non-sinusoidal, then we have to use the KPK. We have to divide by KPK. KPK is called peak factor. So if it is sinusoidal, the KPK will be replaced with root 2. If it is non-sinusoidal, we have to use the KPK. So from the problem statement, we can get the KPK value. So next we need to calculate the loss component current. So here we calculated the IM value. Next we have to calculate the IL value, that is loss component of no load current, IL value. How to calculate IL value? For that we need get the iron loss. So IL is nothing but total iron loss divided by primary voltage, that is VP. So total iron loss divided by VP. So total iron loss is fixed for the particular transformer. So IL equal to PI by VP, which will give the IL value, loss component value. Now we are ready to calculate the no load current. So no load current is nothing but I0 equal to IM square plus IL square, where IM is the magnetizing current. Just now we calculated, then the IL value PI by VP will get the value. By adding these two, we can get the I0 value, where I0 is called no load current for the single phase core type transformer. In the next session, we will discuss about no load current calculation for three phase core type transformer. So if you have any doubt, mail to me.